Good evening. Welcome to South Florida, site of this year's Lingerie Bowl and home of the LFL's Miami Caliente. Tonight, Miami will try and take yet another step toward a playoff berth behind the strong arm of Ananka Dixon and a surprising defense. New York comes in as a major underdog with a recent coaching change and a new scheme. They'll need a standout performance from their franchise quarterback, Crystal Gray, to compete tonight. Where'd you rather be than right here, right now on LFL Friday Night Football?
Let's go. This is the place and the time to decide in your mind if you got what it takes for the shine. Yo! Don't be wasting the time. Yo! Get erased from the line. Yo! Lights and the cameras are flashing. Fans on their feet and it's time for some action. Thunder and lightning, they fighting and clashing. High speed chase, race and keep smashing. LFL!
Welcome back, South Florida. Another absolutely picture-perfect day in Miami today. Fans obviously love it. Here's the Eastern Conference standings. Chicago won that first game, beat Miami in what could eventually be a huge win. Then you've got Miami and Philly. You're going to have to be 3-1 to make the playoffs out of the East. I don't think there's any question about that. And the teams that look good, Chicago, Miami, Philly, but we haven't seen Tampa yet. You never know. Let's take a look at our keys to the game. First of all, Miami comes off a huge win last week. Their ability to focus on the task at hand and not overlook this New York team, tonight's game will be yet another key step toward that playoff berth. And despite a new playbook and coach, New York's posted the second most yards in a game this year, 174 against Philly. Most of it came through the air, catalyst being New York's franchise quarterback, Crystal Gray, and standout wide receiver, Nicole Stanley. And with star running back Kiki Toombs, who rushed for a monster 163 yards last week, missing from the lineup tonight, Miami will have to return to their air attack with the LFL's version of the greatest show on turf, led by all-fantasy quarterback Ananka Dixon, alongside her favorite targets, Tina Calcavelli. We'll be back. Kickoff's coming up next. Finally, a reason to love shopping. Log on to LFLShop.com for your favorite LFL team gear and merchandise. For the LFL fan on the go, simply go to LFLUS.com and download your favorite player and team applications. LFL Mobile, where true fantasy football meets your handset. Welcome back. Tom Doerr here alongside the founder of the LFL, Mitch Mortaza. And Mitch, another big ball game.
Oh, absolutely, Tommy. Good to be here tonight. This is one that's going to be a major battle. It really comes down to Miami and Philadelphia for the second spot in the East. I don't see anybody challenging Chicago for the top one, so this should be a fun one and a message sender for the Miami team.
Yeah, well, especially with that win Chicago had over Miami in that first week. That was huge.
Tina absolutely.
Will kick off, and here we go, brother. Kickoff, and it's fumbled against the sideboard. Oh, was that lucky? That was almost a huge turnover right away.
Did they get that back, Tom?
Yeah, they got it back, I believe.
Well, that would have been a catastrophe right from the start for New York.
There you see the lineups. Very, very good line for New York. They did a great job in their first ball game. And, of course, Nicole Stanley, a wide receiver who could flat catch it. Stephanie Gale, a good running back. And the franchise quarterback, Crystal Gray out of Buffalo, who has thrown it very, very well. She can complete pass.
Yeah, make no mistake about it. This offense will go how Crystal Gray goes tonight, Tom. And we'll see. We'll get a look at her here in the first drive.
First ball, pitch goes to Gale. Oh, she dropped it. Oh, that was big trouble. She dropped it. You saw it bounce a couple times before she controlled that.
Yeah, that's tough. That's got to be nerves right there, I'm thinking. You know, this team is a relatively new team. We hit on it at the Open. We'll see how New York reacts.
Garrett Turley, who we've talked about, is just terrific. As a middle linebacker, she can make play after play after play. And, of course, we talked about Tina Calcavelli on offense. She's an outstanding safety as well. And this is a player who's looking at all leagues because she's one of those great hands players that every quarterback wants.
She plays both ways, Tommy. She's leading the league in interceptions, and she's leading the league in receptions. You can't do much better than that.
Give goes to Stanley. She cuts back along the right side. Boy, the first two plays, the Miami front has just been outstanding.
And they've got to really, really assess that front line and really kind of send a statement that you're not coming through here with that all-fantasy middle linebacker they have in Tara Turley. And look at her step up there.
Third down at about 10 now.
Now look for New York to take a shot here. They do have Nicole Stanley, and she's proven she's got speed, and Crystal Gray certainly has the arm to get it to her.
Gray fades back, looking. Now Pitt tucks it. She's going to run, and she ran into her own player. Had she cut a left a little bit earlier, one step, she might have had huge yardage.
Yeah, she had some open acres on the left side there. But there you go. Crystal shows you that she can beat you with her arm and feet. She's one of those unique quarterbacks in this league, and we'll get a look at it here. And look at her cut back, and she'll take the impact. And this is not a quarterback that's going to take a knee, Tommy. She's a tough cookie.
Oh, no, she's going to fight for every yard she can get. All right, fourth down, fourth and four. Remember, they don't punt in this league, so this has got to go for the first down.
Big play for Miami's defense here.
Complete Gale, and she's fighting forward, and she claws ahead, and she is going to be very close.
I think she got it, Tommy. Looked like she stretched it across. Let's see if we get a measurement or if they're going to give it to her.
What the officials say, and it is going to be Miami ball, and there's Tara Turley right there. Again, dominant at the line of scrimmage. That's one of the huge differences for the teams that have been so successful. Morgan McGrath and, of course, Tina Calcavelli, who's just... She's all league. She is all fantasy. She's terrific. She's got unbelievable hands. And Dixon, their quarterback, is one of those special players in this league. When you've got a quarterback and a receiver like that, you've got a team that can score almost at the drop of a hat.
Oh, yeah. I mean, you're talking about an offense right now that's leading the league, Tom, in receptions and passing. There's not a category they're not. And look at this. They're going to go
Dixon
up top. From
Dixon going long, looking Calcavelli. She's got it. Touchdown. What a reach out and grab. A terrific pickup. And she put six on the board. A little celebration dance. I like it. It's hot in Miami.
Right out of the gate, Tom, over the top. That looked to be, what, about a 40-yard pass on a dime. And they're not wasting any time here.
Stelma, the linebacker, Pink and Glenn, the line. And this is where New York has got to dominate because Miami is great up front. Stephanie Gale, Nicole Rill. This is a defensive backfield that's good, but they're going to have to get pressure on that quarterback. Now,
yeah,
Dixon...
Look for New York to possibly drop more D-backs if this aerial assault continues.
Dixon gets away from one tackler, is in trouble, now cuts back to the right side. Oh, look who's open! Look who's wide open in the end zone! Calcavelli there, the two-point conversion is good. Mitch, is there one player in this league you can't afford to lose?
I think that's it. I think, you know, it wasn't a big surprise. She was going to be her favorite target coming into the game tonight, and they're showing they're a great matchup.
How about a one play? Oh, I love these guys. I love those guys. A one-play drive for Miami, and they score.
Miami's entertaining. Look at this. Right out of the gate, and the extra point. Nice little misdirection, sidesteps, the Michael Vick experience with a knock of Dixon
right,
here.
Right. And then, boy, just that perfectly thrown ball. That's not one you got to fire. That's one to put a little touch on. She did, and 8-0 Miami comes out right away. And now if you're New York, Mitch, you've got to say, hey, we got stopped on our first possession. We have to get something going here.
Yeah, and you're seeing a little bit of the confusion here. They don't even have a center out there, and that comes from having a brand new head coach, new offensive scheme, and having 3 weeks to prepare for this game.
Gray with the run there. Oh, and she went down hard.
Yeah, and you know what? She's not one of the bigger quarterbacks in this league, so we'll see how that body holds up as the season goes as well. She's taken a beating already because there really isn't much of a front line to this New York team right now.
We give her about 4 yards on the game, Tara Turley on the tackle. So let's call it second down and six now. New York, and they take a while in that huddle.
They are, and you know, it's a lot of, I think, confusion at this point, and you can see it evident here from the plays. You know, this is where Crystal Gray has got to take command of this offense, regardless of being so new. She's got to take command.
Hand off, that goes to Stanley over the left side, cuts back. Stanley at about 4 yards on that one. And see, that's, you continually get 4 yards on plays, Mitch. Great things are going to happen.
Yeah, you know, New York's got to, the nerves has got to settle. You know, they're in a big stage here in Miami. I think if they can rope a drive together, stay in this game, and keep the fans on their hands, they're going to stand a chance at this game.
Gray comes up under center, got a little motion coming into the backfield. Now fades back, looking, tucks it, now looking long, throws, and it is intercepted. Taylor Thompson with it. Look at Thompson fight forward. A terrific interception, and Miami is right back knocking on the door.
Yeah, Gray kind of forced it on that play. If we get a replay on it, you'll see that, you know, she was basically almost in the grasp, and that was a last-minute ditch, and you never want to throw it to a receiver that's triple covered. So just a bad, bad decision there by Gray.
Well, now this is a chance for Miami to just tell everybody else in the East, we may have one loss, but you're still going to have to come to Miami and beat us. Miami looks awfully good.
Look for a clinic here, unless this New York defense, especially in the secondary, steps up. And you know what? They might have to do what Chicago did toward the tail end of their game, is literally drop 4 or 5 defenders in the secondary.
Football starts at the 16-yard line. Dixon rolls around, finds Calcavelli. Calcavelli's cocking that arm. She's looking long into the end zone. Touchdown! Taylor Thompson right there. 6 more quick ones for Miami.
How do you stop this offense? You really can't stop it. When you think you can key on Ananka Dixon in the pass, Tina Calcavelli comes around on an end-around reverse on and throws a 20-yard dart. I mean, this offense is putting on a clinic tonight.
And that is really a well-thrown ball, and this crowd is having a great time already. 14-0 Miami, and they're going for 2 again. They are going for the jugular right from the start.
If this would be a heavyweight bout, they'd probably consider stopping this thing soon.
Dixon rolls out to the right side. Oh, the triple option, I love it. The old wishbone offense, and the 2-point conversion is good. That was Michelle Stevens. What is Miami? They've got just trick after trick after trick. I love the wishbone offense.
And they're going to bring a lot of that. They're going to give you different sets tonight. They're going to give you motion. They're going to do everything they can to confuse this young New York defense.
We got a break. We will be right back. Welcome back to Miami. New York already down in this game, 16-0, and they've got to find some answers right now.
Yeah, I think the run game kind of goes out the window here, Tom. They've got to sling the ball. Here we go.
Gray, that's a nice pass to Stephanie Gale, and a very, very nice catch by Gale.
Absolutely. And Gale is somebody that's going to contribute tonight from time to time, but make no mistake about it, Nicole Stanley is going to be the go-to target.
Trips to the right side. And it's a nice first down.
Yeah, and you know, that middle of the defense is probably going to be open from time to time because Tara Turley tends to rush more than drop. So if they can get it over that front line, they're going to have a sweet spot right where Tara Turley's supposed to be.
Gray still looking at the play calls on her wrist. Now gets the motion. Hands off. This is Stanley. Comes around the left side. Stanley with a nice game. Oh, what a tackle. Oh, she went down hard on that one.
Yep, that's our good friend Tina Cacavelli, and a little bit of after-play shenanigans there. But Cacavelli, yeah, she stepped up.
Call it a gain of about 6 there, make it 2nd down and 4. Now, New York with a nice little drive going. They had something going last time till the interception, but this is a Miami team that just likes to attack. What a difference from week 1 when they played Chicago.
Yeah, absolutely. I think you're just seeing a team that's more confident, that has a little more swagger. They went into Philly and got that big win, and it's translating tonight.
Gray comes around the right side on a keeper, and a tough run for her. And she is going to be very, she's got a first down and more for her, as now New York seems to have found a little seam here.
Yeah, and you saw Crystal Gray's wheels there, Tom. She can move.
She's a very talented player.
And this is the dilemma for New York, and it's been the case in their first game. They'll move the ball on you. They just make the big mistake here in the red zone. So let's see if they can put something on the board versus turn the ball over, which has been the story all season.
First and goal. Little pitch right side. That's Stanley. Stanley gets away from one tackler inside the five, and then she runs into a wall of Miami tacklers and got no further. But a gain of a couple there. See if they mark her down at about the 4 or 5 yard line. So New York knocking on the door.
Yeah, and you've got to keep pace with this offense. We've said it all along. You know, they've got to come away with 7 points here.
Yeah, this is not a situation where you can think about six. Six doesn't get it done. Football down, they'll mark it down at the 3 yard line. Remember, quarterback Gray has run the ball very well as throw it, and that's what she's going to do. She's got a keeper going around the left side trying to get in, and she is very close.
Did she
the
get
official
in?
Says, no, she didn't. The official's marking her down at about the 1 yard line, maybe inside the one.
Wow, I thought she got in when she got around that corner. They might have pushed her out inside the one here. Let's take a look.
Well, this is the pass from a second ago. Boy, that's where that Miami defense just really stood her up. Look at the football right down at the 1 yard line. See if you see Stanley right there in your picture. Give goes to her, a little bit of a mix up, and she's going to lose yardage. She lost a couple there. And again, Mitch, this is not having started from the beginning with this coaching staff. They're just not sure.
That's exactly right. You're seeing a lot of confusion, a lot of misdirection. They didn't have a center to open out the game. So it's, you know, it's hurting them here. And this is where they've got to just buck up as a team and say, hey, listen, let's put all that aside. And let's communicate and get this thing in the end zone. This has been their Achilles heel all season, getting inside the red zone and coming away with no points.
Well, they've got to throw the ball. This is fourth down. She does, throws, and it's a little behind the receiver and incomplete. Might have had a little early motion by Miami there, but it looks like they got away with it.
Yeah, they might have, but once again, here we go. Miami got the stop, and now they're going to gain possession of this ball. That was the play previous, and as you can see, there was definite miscommunication.
Well, now Miami up 16-0, and New York needs a little something good here. They've got to get a turnover. They've got to get a stop. Something good has got to happen in this possession, you'd think, for New York defensively. They've got to buck up. This is a big one.
Yeah, 7:42 left. You know, plenty of time for Miami to post probably another 40 points the way this offense is operating.
Aren't they? They are like the old Los Angeles Lakers, the way they just run up and down the field.
Oh, it's showtime. I'm half waiting for Kareem to come out of the stands. This is fun.
By the way, I heard he's sick. I hope he does well. Kareem is one of the all-time greats. There's Dixon. Fades back in her own end zone. She wants to throw it. She's looking long. Looking Calcavelli out behind everybody else. Touchdown, Miami.
High stepping it into the end zone.
Oh, my goodness. They have had, what, 3 one-play drives, Mitch, and all 3 touchdowns.
Here's the defensive coordinator for Miami, for New York. All he should be preaching is keep the girls, keep the receivers in front of you, not behind you. Miami's getting behind the secondary every play. They've got to keep the action in front of them, and they're getting burned on these 40-yard darts from Dixon.
How about New York? How about Miami going for a 3rd 2-point conversion? I just got a full house backfield behind her. Dixon starts right, now goes back left. She's got a little trouble trying to get around the corner, trying to go back again, and she stopped. Well, that's the first time that New York has been able to stop Miami at anything so far in this game.
And why not go to the well again? They haven't stopped anything, so why not go for a 2-point conversion?
All right, we got a break. Wow, what a show for Miami. We will be right back. back to Miami. 22-0, the home team in control. And Crystal Gray, the quarterback, fades back. She's looking long throws, and it is tapped a couple times and incomplete. It'll be 2nd and 10. Feel like you've got something going, like you're making progress, you can chip away at this, we can do this. You got to come up with something. I agree. Give a fumble on the reverse, and boy, they are just having problem after problem after problem. Reverse hand up. That's tough. She actually, instead of putting that in the belly, when you hand the ball, you got to slap it into that belly. She kind of flipped that. That's impossible. Well, it's not impossible, but hard to catch that. Fades back, looking, steps up, throws. She got hit as she throws, and the ball is incomplete. Talk to all the great NFL coaches of all time, the college coaches of all time. They'll tell you, yeah, you need a great quarterback. You need a great middle linebacker. But football starts and ends with your line. Your offensive line and your defensive line have to be absolutely terrific, or you're going to struggle. And that's just how it is. There's just no two ways about it. And so in this game with line play, when you can rush two and the other team doesn't know when that's going to happen, offensively, you have to be ready for almost anything. So a timeout, and now you've got to think there's been a bit of discussion going on because they've got to get on the same page. That's really what it comes down to. You've got to find a way, and it's tough with a new team.
It's communication. It's communication, and that's what's going on the sideline. It looks like they've got Nicole Stanley at quarterback now.
On 4th and 12, Stanley fades back. She's going to throw it. She's looking long. What an arm on Stanley, and it's incomplete. Mitch, who knew? Holy shnikes, she can fire that ball.
Yeah, they're pulling out all the stops. There's got to be something there that gets them some points. So look for Stanley to maybe sub in here. Let's see if she stays in.
Threw that ball well and just did miss. Well, now, this is really time for Miami to deliver a knockout punch, basically. New York thought, yeah, we can get something, but now this is really trouble.
Yeah, if you stop him here and you score again, lights out, this one's over.
Well, it's been one play drive so far. We haven't seen a lot of time of possession for Miami. They aren't winning that battle. We'll take a break and come right back. Knockout punch. Ananka Dixon, their quarterback, back in the familiar shotgun, hands off, the reverse again, in some trouble. Now Calcavelli is looking. She's looking long, throws, and it is incomplete. Nice job by the New York defense. I think after the first one, they realized we can't let them get behind us.
Yeah, you know, I think what they're starting to do is maybe they can hear us through the broadcast. They're dropping people. You can see they're dropping two or three additional D-backs here, and Calcavelli just didn't have much place to go with it here, so she just slings it, and Dixon almost came down with it.
Nice job by Jess Stelma, the defensive line for New York, to put a little pressure there. Calcavelli had to roll out and find something. Now, yeah, second and 10.
New York's given up 41 points on average, so this certainly isn't surprising. I guess the ease of it all is really what's surprising to me here.
Second down and 10. And we got a penalty.
Looks like Morgan McGrath might have started a little early there.
So now second and 15. And, you know, if you're Miami at this point in time, and I don't mean to sound crass, but if you're Miami at this point in time, you got to think, oh, that's just a little more room for us to operate here. Football's at the 18-yard line. It's second and 15. They got to get to the 3. They're not thinking about a first down.
No, and we're certainly not kicking any field goals. There's no field goals in the NFL game. So this is good old sandlot football. Wind it up, let her go, let the receiver run under it, just like that.
And look at Thompson, just rolls into the end zone, touchdown.
Oh, it is just too easy right now.
It really is, and Miami, with all the weapons that they have, Mitch, back to the first game to now, you talked about a terrific coaching job by Bobby Uecko. He has really, really transformed this team.
Yeah, and he's using multiple weapons now. You know, and that was Taylor Thompson. We've seen Calcavelli. There are multiple players here that are contributing. Michelle Stevens, the call.
On the play, first and foul, defense, number 10. That 10-yard penalty, it'll be assessed at the succeeding spot. Try.
So a personal foul there, it sounded like, on New York, which is going to back them up that much more after this kickoff.
Boy, oh boy, New York. And you hate to pick on them because, again, it's a brand new coach, a new system, but they just can't get anything right now, unfortunately. Dixon, little give on the one-point conversion. And even when that's Morgan McGrath who takes it in, Mitch, even when things go wrong, like the little problem they had on the handoff there, they still go right for Miami.
Oh, and look at this. They're playing with their fans. They're just loving every moment of this. And why not? Why not? It's South Florida. You're playing for a playoff berth. You're up 28 to nothing right now. Why not celebrate?
The little problem they had on the handoff right there. Yeah, and you know what? Have fun. That's what this is about. You're up 29-0, but still, you want to have fun playing football.
Yeah, you're sending a message to the league, and it's loud and clear. This is going to be a contender, and make no mistake about it, Chicago and the Windy City are watching this one.
Oh, they're watching every second of this. Now, the personal foul and New York. Boy, they start at their own 7-yard line instead of the 15, so it's half the distance to the goal on that personal foul. And Stanley in again instead of Gray. Stanley looking long, lobs it, and it is incomplete, and it'll be second down.
Yeah, they're taking their shots, just they have no receivers that can run under these balls right now.
Well, because Stanley is their best receiver, and that's a problem when you've got a player like her who can do so many different things. When you take her out of something, you lose a lot. We'll take a break and come right back. Welcome back, South Florida, New York with the football, and they are backed up due to a personal foul. First play was an incomplete pass. It's second and 10. Stanley remains in at quarterback. She fades back. Looking, rolls out to the right side. Now she's going to tuck it and keep it. Oh, and she hit hard. Out at the 13-yard line. And look at Miami, talking a little trash too, Coach. I like it.
Yeah, it's getting heated down there, Tommy. And you can see here, Stanley really gives them the option of a pass or a run play. And she's a little more stout than Gray, so she can take some of these hits.
Almost had a little wardrobe malfunction there. Faded down and kept on running.
Yeah, I think Stanley's going to give them a good shot at success here. Let's see if they can march it down the field and at least get some points on the board, get some kind of momentum going here.
Third down and four. And New York again, here they come. Miami trying to get this big crowd going. They want some noise in this place. Stanley stays in at quarterback. Rolls out. That's a quarterback keeper, and look at this. She's got a first down and more.
Hey, if nobody can do it around you, do it yourself, and that's what's happening with Nicole Stanley right now. She's a one-woman wrecking crew.
So that's a very nice first down, and here comes Crystal Gray right back in now.
And you know, they're spreading out Gray. It looks like almost in a wildcat formation. She's going out playing receiver. And she's got some wheels, so maybe they can take a shot with her down the field. You can see her spreading. Oh, no, she's under center now.
Yeah, she's going to be back under center, yep. Gray fades back. She's looking to throw. Got a little pressure hit as she throws, and it's incomplete. And she really has not had the time, Mitch, to go back and look for that open receiver.
And not only that, she is battling a strained shoulder from the Philadelphia game that I'm not sure is completely healed up right now, but she's not one to make excuses, but they've got to get something going here.
With just 14 seconds left in the half, and the officials having a little conference here. Maybe talking to the clock operator, Mitch. It seems like they're trying to put more time back on the clock.
Yeah, it looks,
that's my guess.
Looks like they're running the clock when it should have stopped. So look for some more, so a few more seconds there. They're up to 27.
Oh, substantially more. Yeah, exactly. Great job by the crew to be right on top of that. Now up to 38.
Give New York a 28. Give them 5 minutes. I don't think it's going to matter. This team's not doing much.
No, it's, and the thing with Miami, there you see Turley right there. Turley, they're stopped. Turley's ready right now,
yeah.
Even though they're stopped. There's no action. She's still like, bring it on.
She's the Mike Singletary of this league. We should get a close-up on those eyes.
Little pressure. Stanley gets away. Oh, wow. And a fumble. A fumble. Let's see if they say she was down. How about that hit? Oh, Mitch, that was a shot.
Where did that come from? I know Stanley didn't see it.
Never saw that coming. Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, we get a replay on that. It's, you know, it's Turley. Turley is having one heck of a game here. You know, offensively, defensively, this is about as sound a football team as it comes in the LFL. And they're definitively sending a message to Chicago and Philadelphia tonight. And who knows? Here we go. We have 17 seconds, Tommy. What's the over-under on another 7 points here?
I think the question is how many seconds, and is it 7 or 8?
Yeah.
Dixon calls for the football. She'll fade back. Rolls out to the right side. She's going to keep it. Now she changes field, goes back to the left side. Here's a juke move. Gets inside the 15, down near the 10. Fumbles the football. It's loose. Then we got a pile up down there. Let's see who's got it. On the bottom, it looks like it is New York. They get it right back.
Oh, that's great. Anything. I think New York can take anything to try to build on it. That, once again, it was Anaka Dixon with the Michael Vick experience out there, but looks like she lost handle on the hit.
For the change of possession, LA go block in the back. Offense number 9. That penalty was declined.
Yeah, they'll decline that. Yep, they declined the penalty.
That was an illegal block in the back.
And you can see Dixon, she's got feet. I mean, she clearly cuts all the way back across, and it looks like she lost the ball with impact.
See if we can see it. Oh no, it was out. It was out well before. And you know what? I got to tell you, these two teams have already developed a very nice, strong dislike for each other. Stanley tucks it, gets away from one tackler, kind of stopped, now fumbled the football. And let's see what they call this. Oh, look at this. Look at that head.
Oh.
We got two teams ready to rumble here.
Yeah, you know, I'm not seeing a lot of Christmas cards being exchanged between these two groups. There's definitely some tension out there right now.
It's halftime. We'll be back.
You're under the lights and you change every week. I'm sick of it. No pride, no guts, no balls, nothing. You want to call yourself a football player? You have some goddamn emotion on the field, which you have none of. You're posers. You are posers. Football players don't act like this.
As an athlete, you've got to understand a coach is going to challenge you every once in a while. Coach Racist just did that to his team. All right, first half highlights, Mitch. And here's the reason that he was so upset. This is all Miami.
Oh, they dominated throughout. You can see defensively they stepped up. Offensively, they just had an aerial assault all night there with Cacavelli and Dixon. It was all Miami throughout, and you're going to be upset when your team gets dominated the way Miami was.
Love those fans. Love the players. Miami just having fun. They're just having a great time playing football and doing everything that they can do, and first half numbers are going to show it. When you double the other team in yards, and you have four turnovers. Now you got the three fourth down conversions, the one interception. It ends up, you get four stops. That's huge in indoor football. We'll take a break. Second half coming up. Stick around, LFL Friday Night Football.
Men, finally, a reason to love shopping. Log on to LFLShop.com for your favorite LFL team gear and merchandise. For the LFL fan on the go, simply go to LFLUS.com and download your favorite player and team applications. LFL Mobile, where true fantasy football meets your handset.
Well, if you're a Miami fan, you are dancing around having a great time. 29-0. Miami over New York, and we didn't get much of a chance to talk. Quite a halftime speech by the New York coach.
Yeah, fired up, Coach Racich. He's a New Yorker at heart, and you saw a little bit of that come out in the locker room. And I don't know, you know, you look up at the scoreboard as a New York player, you see that you're down 29-0. You get that speech at halftime. Not only do you have potentially the best team in the LFL staring you during the second half, but your morale, you know, your morale's got to be low now. So we'll see if they stand any chance at this thing. But I don't see anything being different from the first half. Though.
And look at these Miami players. They are out there having fun, celebrating, getting the fans involved. You've got to give them a lot of credit. They're just having a great time playing football.
Yeah, and it shows in the scoreboard and the effort. You know, the other team looks like a deer caught in headlights, and Miami's out there playing this like a preseason game at this point. They're just having fun.
It's really strong. We'll kick off for New York, and how about this? You're down 29-0, and you got to kick it off to Miami. Yikes.
Yeah, we'll see if the Miami decides to kind of sit on this ball with Coach Hugo, or if he's going to continue to go for the jugular here.
Nice kick. Picking it about the 7. Williams cuts back, runs into her own player. Look out if she gets away, but she can't quite. And they'll have it at about the 21-yard line. Nice return. She waited for her blockers and then made a little move.
Yeah, that looks like Cacavelli. Is there anything that this girl does not do for the Miami team? Maybe she cooks for them as well.
Drives the bus the whole bit.
She's a standout at safety. She's obviously arguably the best receiver in the game, and now she's returning kicks to quite a star.
Well, yeah, if she's not the best receiver, she has the best hands. What I've seen her do is, and we haven't seen Tampa yet, but what I've seen her do is incomparable.
She's deceptively fast, too. You wouldn't imagine it by her tall, lanky frame, but she can get down the field as we saw in the first half.
All right, so it's first down at the 21-yard line. Dixon on a keeper, rolls around the left side, looking to hang on to it. Now cuts back, goes along the right side, looking to make a move. She's inside the 20, and then wrestled down and wrestled down hard at the end of that play.
Yeah, she's having fun. That time New York brought the blitz. They brought three people, which could have drawn a flag in it itself. It looks like they did draw a flag on it.
See her cut back right here. This is where she is so dangerous, because she's just looking for that little angle. And it's a stop and a flag down. And that is a personal foul against New York.
Personal foul, yeah. I thought they might have gotten him on the three players rushing, but New York certainly cannot afford any penalties right now if they want any shot at this thing.
Football at the 23-yard line. Dixon fades, little lob pass, and it's incomplete. And that one she didn't really throw. She just kind of pushed them.
Yeah, you know, that's the only time. New York hasn't really stopped Miami. It's been, if anything, Miami, and it goes an incomplete here and there. But they're doing what they want to do out here. Let's see if they get a little trickery. It looks like the New York team is rushing up the field. Maybe that'll open up the sidelines a little bit.
Well, and that may have been what they're doing right there. If you're going to rush three, which you're not supposed to, but if you're going to rush three, we'll throw a little lob pass there. Here's what they're doing. Pass goes to the right side. Boy, terrific job defensively. And now a flag down. Is that a flag or is that a...
Looks like a flag, Tommy. And that was Nicole Stanley in the flag.
People can see what the flag might be here. Oh, that's one of her towels. See the towels on her waist?
Oh, yeah, that's the rally towels. They got the rally towels going. Yeah, and you saw a great tackle there by Nicole Stanley. So there are some bright spots on this New York team, namely Nicole Stanley and Crystal Gray. Let's see if the rest of this defense can step up.
Dixon fades back. That's a lateral. A lateral back to Dixon. Now Dixon looking long. What else is new? And it's caught. Oh, my. I couldn't see. Is it Thompson on the catch? I think so. How about this? Again, just having a great time. That's one where you draw it out in the sand. When you're a little kid, you say, all right, you do this. You throw it back to me. I'll throw it back to you, and then we'll look long.
Is this even fair, Tommy? Is this even fair? This is like little sisters of four here, and Miami's taking advantage of it.
Unbelievable. Just unbelievable. They have so many weapons. It's down to the 8-yard line to make it the 7-yard line.
And look at that offensive line. That offensive line, Kaylee Tuning, Morgan McGrath, and Tara Turley has really given Dixon some time.
Dixon rolls out to the right side. It's the wishbone. This time she's going to follow her blocker, put the hand in front, and she is in for the touchdown.
The bleeding continues for New York. The bleeding continues.
Wow. Look at when somebody's having this much fun, it's infectious. You see the crowd. They're having a great time.
Oh, yeah. Anka Dixon just plays right in their hands, a little option. She keeps it, rolls it right into the end zone, and New York doesn't have any defense in there.
35-0. Wow. Oh, I tell you, again, I said this earlier, you go back to the first game and where they've come to from that first game, this is a juggernaut here.
And look at the confidence Hugo's showing in his offense. He's going for two every play. When was the last time we saw that?
Yeah, the two-point conversion and good again. My goodness. She just rolled around the right end. Miami is doing absolutely anything they want to do.
Morgan McGrath, very, very silently, is having a pretty good game herself.
Yeah, good point. Good point. Yep, very good point, Nick. Look at this, Miami, Caliente. The infection, you can just feel it building in the LFL and down here in Miami. I think this is going to be a terrific team and a lot of fun to be around.
And great momentum going into Lingerie Bowl 7. That'll be played right here in South Florida alongside the Super Bowl. And I got a feeling this team might have to something to say about the outcome of Lingerie Bowl 7, the way they're playing tonight.
Boy, they are just terrific. And, you know, we've talked about Chicago. You can't forget Philly. Philly is a heck of a team, but that was a big win by Miami. All right, now New York gets it back, and they've got to find some answers. Gray. Looked like she got a little confused there on a delayed draw. And that'll get him some yards. That's actually a pretty nice play for New York. That little delayed draw looks like some confusion. And Rill is there with a good carry.
Yeah, not sure Nicole Rill was supposed to get that, but it worked out and they chewed up, it looks like, about 11 or 12 yards on that play.
Quite a first down. Looks like about second and two. Yeah, they must have said that knee came down. Yeah, the knee came down, they say, out at the 22, 23 yard line. So second down and a couple. Stanley comes around the left side. She's got a first down and more. Oh, and a tough tackle at the end. Stanley kind of readjusts that face mask. That's a tough tackle. But she got some nice yardage. Oh, she is, yeah.
She's a gladiator for these girls. And you know what? If it takes you to just put this team on your back, that's what you got to do at this point. And Stanley's showing that. You know, she's not going to lay down here and take this Buffalo bit of 37-0 and try to have something to say about it.
Well, maybe that's somebody that listened to the coach at halftime and thought, I've had enough. You know,
yeah.
I don't care what the score is. I'm going to play hard. Gray in at quarterback. Little pitch goes to the right side. Rill there gets the 15 inside of there down to about the 13-yard line. And New York, again, with a nice drive going. We'll see if they can continue. We got a timeout on the field. 37-0 Miami all over New York. They have been so good. Here's the little pitch and catch and run. A nice play. New York's had a few of those, but it has been all Miami. Happy South Florida. These fans are dancing, they're cheering, they are having a ball here and watching some LFL Friday Night Football. They're loving their team. Little throw, Rill's got it, and she's going to be stopped right there.
Ooh. Yeah, this crowd's having fun. Ain't no party like an LFL Friday Night Football party, I guess.
They are just having the time of their life. And this is a great crowd.
Oh, they're charged up here. And, you know, New York is trying to get something going here, even amidst all the crowd noise and celebration that started really early. But, you know, like you said, New York has got it. Nothing else but pride punch this thing in the end zone.
Gray back at quarterback now. Football at the 8-yard line. Gray calling out the play. Rill's kind of a slot back there. And it is going to be the give. Rill cuts back, goes around the outside, and she is in for the touchdown.
There you go.
Obviously, it's not going to change the end of this game, the outcome, but New York at least has to feel good about that.
Yeah, you got to get that goose egg off the scoreboard. And that's the big thing, no matter what sport you play or what level you play, men or women, you know, when you're being blanked, got a big scoreboard facing you. That's tough, you know, and luckily New York got it in to at least post some points here.
37-6 now as New York will go for one.
I figured the comeback's out, so they're not going for two.
That's a good point. Gray rolls around the right side, keep her all the way, and she is in for the extra point.
There you go.
Yeah, and get something. To get something out of that nice drive. And Gray's excited.
Yeah, Gray. I mean, it's what? They score once every blue moon. So when they do, it's celebration comes out. Here's Gray, just an easy quarterback keeper along the right side. And gets in for the extra point.
10-17 left. And, you know, we can talk about the West for a second because we've said that Dallas has clinched. I guess there's a scenario, you're more the mathematician than I am. You were telling me that Dallas, Seattle, and L.A. can all end up 3-1. What's the story there?
Yes, I mean, right now, you know, we're trying to get a sense for the playoff pictures, even though it's only week 10 in the LFL. each of these teams only play four games, so each game has playoff implications. In the West, it's interesting because we could potentially have all 3-1 teams up top and point differential comes in. So, you know, rest assured, maybe that's the reason Miami's, you know, still kind of have the foot on the pedal here, because if it ever comes down to head-to-head and point differentials, all these points are going to matter. So maybe that's what Hucco's doing here.
And that's Calcavelli there. A 10-yard gain. It's right at the first down. Mark Dixon with just a nice little pitch there. And when you got Calcavelli there, that you can throw that little pitch, you see her open, there are no more decisions to make, because she's got such great hands and great moves that you're going to give her the football. And it was enough for a first down.
Yeah, you know, I mean, this is kind of a Montana Rice-type formula that we saw in the 80s with the Niners. These two are getting really comfortable with each other. You could see whether it's a 40-yard dart or just a quick screen pass. Like you said, Tommy, Dixon's getting very comfortable with Cacavelli, and these two are going to be, you know, someone to deal with down the road here, especially in the playoffs.
Oh, now here's the hidden ball trick. Who's got it? There it is on the right side, 20. 15, and finally driven back down.
Okay, now they're really going to the bag of tricks. That was the old fumble rooski, I think, with Morgan McGrath keeping it.
How about that? Again, we keep talking about it. They're having a great time. Look at this.
Yeah, you know, at this point, you get to have fun as a head coach, too, an offensive coordinator. You kind of throw the playbook out, and you say, hey, let's just have some fun out here. That's what Coach Hucco's doing.
And if you're the one getting the football, you're like, this is really cool. I love this game. Football's down at the 14 right now. It was McGrath on the carry a second ago.
Look at this.
How about this? Same play. The exact same play. Look at her go. Inside the 10, down near the 5-yard line.
If it ain't broke, don't fix it. Right, Tommy? And why not run it again?
And New York's getting a little upset. They are not enjoying this. Obviously, if you're on the losing end of this, this is no fun. But the same kind of hidden ball trick twice in a row, I can see they'd get a little upset.
Yeah. I mean, you got to keep your composure here. You're still a professional athlete. And New York's, Miami's going to do what they can get away with. So if you can't defend it, they're going to keep bringing it, obviously.
Football down at the 6-yard line. Dixon lost the handle, and she will be down right there. Bring it back to about the 15. It's Michelle Stevens who came up with it. A fumbled snap. I think Dixon just looked up. She just tried to see who was going to be open. No, it was a bad snap.
Yeah, that was just a bad snap, and luckily it looks like Michelle Stevens is there to fall on that ball and try to advance it. New York here, I mean, no matter what you've done in the first half, you got to get it out of your head. This is a whole new half. Regardless of the score, block it out and just play football.
Receivers to both sides. Dixon fades back, looking. Now she's going to tuck it and run, gets around the initial rush, goes down the left side. She's got a first down and more. She got everything right back from that fumble.
She could have braided her hair back there the amount of time that she had. New York has got to bring somebody up the middle, even if it's just one rusher. You cannot give this quarterback that kind of time.
37-7, and we got a break. We will be back. Welcome back, LFL Friday Night Football, 37-7, Miami with the lead. Just under 6.5 left here, and Miami knocking at the door again.
Love it.
Now, first and goal.
Look for, they've got Morgan McGrath in the backfield. They've been highlighting her this entire drive. Let's see if she can finish it.
And it is going to be Dixon. Oh, nice little scoot play, and she's in for the touchdown.
I believe that's an LFL record 43 points. I don't think anybody's posted 43 this season.
Oh, good point. Yeah, I think you're right.
And
it has just been all Miami.
You know, this
defensively is what we haven't talked much about. And their defense, and they're going to go for an extra point here, as you see Dixon just kind of roll in from the right side. Mitch, their defense has been terrific.
Oh, yeah. The defense is holding their own, and this offense doesn't need much help.
Dixon Rolls around the right side. Pitches it out, and McGrath is going to be stopped right there hard.
Good hit by Stanley there.
You got to give Stanley a lot of credit. She has not at all quit. She's playing hard, but Miami is still celebrating.
Yeah, it's the old Archie Manning syndrome. You know, he was on the Saints.
Down in New Orleans, yeah.
You know, that team struggled for years and years. He was a standout, and I think that's a little bit of that going on with New York right now. But they'll be back. They'll be back. You know, keep in mind, once again, this team's been together for 4 weeks under Coach Racich, going into the offseason this year, get some new blood in there and have a full season of mini camps and training camps, and they'll be back.
Yeah, and they'll be a lot better. I agree with you. They've got talent on that team. They just need to fill a couple holes and be together for a whole season. That'll be a big part of it.
Absolutely.
All right, that's turning, I think, at the quarterback and the give. Right there goes to Stanley, cuts back, and she got about 6 yards on that play. What do you do? I mean, what do you do to try and stop them? I don't see them much. When they run like this, New York is very effective. Great blocking upfield.
Yeah, I don't know why New York really hasn't stayed with the run. I guess it's because of the score. But, you know, when it's this lopsided and you know you don't have a shot to get back in it, keep it on the ground and do what you've been doing well and leave this game with something positive at least. And they're doing quite a bit of a carousel at quarterback. I see Gray's back in there.
Gray fades back. Got a little pressure, looking long, throws. It's tipped. Oh, what a pickup! That's just Elmo. Wow.
The immaculate reception there. I'd like to see a replay on that one.
That was a good call. Yeah, very nice call.
Immaculate because they caught the ball, not so much the immaculate reception from the Steelers. It's, I guess you'll take what you can at this point.
Yeah, tip ball and Stelma right there. That's the old tip drill. She was ready. First and 10, they've got it at the Miami. Up the 14-yard line now. Gray, little pitch right side. Stanley, and she's going to fight for a couple. And not much going there.
Not much there. And Miami's, I see they're putting in a couple second stringers in there. So maybe they're starting to relax up a little bit. But don't count on it, I guess.
Well, you give everybody a chance to play. But, yeah, you tell them you play hard. Now, we may not throw the ball. We're going to run the ball. But you play hard. And New York trying to get a win.
And, boy, does this set up a blockbuster matchup here. I think in January when Tampa comes down here to Miami, that'll be the game that Miami needs to clinch and go ahead into the postseason. So that'll be a fun one to watch.
Oh, yeah. Give goes to Stanley. She comes around the left side, stood up about the 7, and she's going to go down right there.
They're keeping it on the ground. At this point, you just want to get out of this game healthy. You know, you want to have the team kind of leave with some positivity, and then they're doing that on the ground here. Crystal Gray with a quick handoff to Stanley, and Stanley's a beast. I don't know why they didn't use more.
Yeah. And I like the positivity. I thought that was a very, very nice use of the English language. Positivity. That's good.
Hey, I logged a good two and a half years of college, so.
There you go. Why not? All right, great. They're knocking on the door here. Make it 3rd down and 4, and she's in trouble. Look out! She's going down. And who is it? It's Tara Turley one more time.
Boy, oh boy. She's somebody to reckon with there in the center. And there's a reason she's an all-fantasy. Look at it. She's loving it. Up in the crowd, the old Lambo leap. You don't see that on defense that often, but when you're posting the kind of stats she is, why not?
So it's 4th down now.
Yeah,
this is great for them. They're having a ball. Why not? Clock running, you can see, coming up on the 2-minute mark. Trip receivers to the right side now for Gray. Calls out the play. Steps up in the pocket, throws, and it's incomplete. She may have been over the line of scrimmage. She had to be really close, but the pass is incomplete, and Miami will take over.
Yeah, it's not much going on right now. And at this point, it's we'll see if Miami comes back, takes a knee, or continues their march.
Yeah, we've got a timeout on the field. 43-7. We'll be back. Welcome back to a very happy Miami, Florida. 43-7. These fans are having a ball. Doesn't matter if it's a timeout. They're still having a great time.
And the players are loving it, too, just angsting on that crowd. It's a fun, fun night to be a part of LFL Friday Night Football.
So they'll get the ball.
Looks like Dixon's still a quarterback, which kind of surprises me, being up a good 36 points here.
She is, and she's fading back. They want to throw the football. She's looking long, fires this one down the field, and it's incomplete.
Yeah, you know, this is, you want to talk about tension and being upset as a New York player. You got to wonder why New York, or Miami that is still opening it up and taking shots.
And we got a hold.
Maybe the point differential is something that's sticking with Coach Hugo, because I cannot understand why else you would still have your starting lineup in the game when you're up 36 points here.
Yeah, there's not a lot of reason. The game is over. The decision has been made here. But I was surprised at that pass, and look at this. She's looking long again. Steps up in the pocket, throws, and it is incomplete. She was really trying to fire that in there for Calcabelli.
Looking for her favorite target again.
Why not, right? And it's like you say, it's got to be that point differential that's playing on his mind. He knows what's going on out west, and he's thinking, hey, you know what? Tampa could end up 3-1. Chicago could be 3-1. Philly could be 3-1. We could be 3-1. There's no telling how this works out.
That, or, you know, he used to be a gunslinger with the Florida Gators, and he posted points under Mike Shanahan, so he could just love offense.
You might have a real good point there. Look at this. She's fading back again. She's looking again. Throws, and it is caught by Thompson. Makes a move. Cuts across the field. Trying to cut back, and she's going to go down.
The weapons are on full display in South Florida tonight. Is there anybody they haven't used in that bench yet?
Well, I can't imagine anybody they haven't thrown the football to. It's a 13-yard gain. That's enough for a first down. They just keep rolling. They just flat keep rolling.
And look at these numbers for Ananka Dixon. She's doing it both on the ground and through the air.
Oh, they had a little fake play. How about that? Dixon started to go toward the sideline. Direct snap to McGrath, and she's down to the 9-yard line. Boy, I was completely fooled, Mitch. She had me dead to rights.
I was going to start calling into a timeout. I don't know. Oh, look at this. Some words being exchanged.
A little taunting back and forth. That's such a good play. I don't know that I would have used it there.
Yeah, I think they've used everything here.
Oh, my goodness. That's amazing. That's a heck of a fake. I was completely taken out. I thought we had a timeout.
That was some
45 seconds left. And Dixon, again, as you said, still in at quarterback.
Miami's making a – New York made a very last-minute substitution there.
Now she throws, and it is caught for a touchdown. Ooh, and a little extra shove. I don't know if you saw that. After she came down, there was a shot, and there's a little trash-talking going on back and forth. That's Gray, the New York quarterback.
And that's Cacavelli pointing at the scoreboard.
Yeah, and that's exactly what I would say, too. What are you crowing about? You're getting murdered.
And look at this. I think Miami's going for two again.
Well, when you get, you know, I guess you could see it both ways, but when you get a late hit like that, you're upset.
Yeah, and I don't know if it's that as much as it's a bruised ego. When any team puts up 49 on you and they're going for two here with 29 seconds left, it's going to eat at you a little bit.
And look at this. He's got the I formation behind Dixon. Dixon with a give, cut to the right side, and she is going to go down hard.
That's Stanley again, I think.
Oh, and look at this. Gray comes in with a little push and a shove, and now we got a little talking and a little pushing and shoving. Look out, Mitch, this could escalate.
Oh, look at this. The refs need to step in here.
Oh, there's a shot. There was a right throw and another right by Gray.
Oh, this is getting out of hand. This is not something we want in this game. This is, the crowd might be loving it, but it's getting out of hand.
Nicole Stanley trying to get Gray, and now there's more fisticuffs all over here.
You can't have this. The crowd's loving it, but this is not what we are about here in Illinois.
Wow, we'll take a break and we will be right back. Hey, Mitch. We saw fist thrown. We saw a headlock. We saw players thrown down. That was a heck of a fight, but you know, you don't like to see it, but they got after it. Here's the official. All right, so that's Gray from New York who's been ejected, and it's Cacavelli and Turley who have been ejected from Miami.
Yeah, it's you don't want to see that. I mean, look, it's fun, it's exciting for the fans. I'm sure the folks watching tonight are loving every second of it. But, you know, it really does kind of take away from the game. And it's been one heck of a game despite the score. It's been a thrilling game. And you certainly don't want this to be what's remembered from this game. That was, you know, that's something that needs to be avoided. And Crystal Gray is one of the leaders of this league. She's a face of the league. She can't be out there engaging in that kind of activity. I know it's a passionate sport and it's an intense sport when you're caught up in the moment, but that was disgusting.
And now they're telling Cacavelli that she is out, that she has been tossed out, and she's gonna skip off and hop over. Look out, she almost went down. And she's all right.
Yeah, she's having fun with it. You know, it's just something that got out of hand, and you know, you kind of expected it. It was building up all game long, especially with the score. Gray's doing.
This is not. There, nothing good can happen from her being up in the stands.
Yeah, this is it's mind-boggling how you can be up in the stands when the score is 49-7, conversing with fans. Rest assured, this will be addressed by the league.
You got to think so. I mean, of course, we are talking to the boss of the league, so I guess we can pretty well with authority say, yeah, you can make whatever decision you call.
Yeah, at this point, you got 29 seconds. You know, snap the ball.
Let's get out of here. Yeah.
Call it a game.
Stanley fades back. There's no quitting her. Look at her. Look at Stanley go. 49-7, she's dragging a player ahead for a first down.
There you go. You know, that's still fighting her. These girls are from New York. They're not going to just go by the wayside depending on the score. They're going to fight. Stanley's impressed a lot of people tonight.
Over there talking to the coach right now. I'm impressed. That kind of a play really impresses me. Because of what the score is, she's not giving up.
Yeah, you know, and if nothing else, this girl's, you know, with the fight and everything tonight, they've proven once again this is real football. Heck, we're playing a game in Denver not so many weeks ago with 12-degree weather.
Oh, it was snowing and cold, and they just played football.
Yeah, it doesn't matter to these girls, and they're really starting to impress people and build new fan bases. We're very excited about where this game is headed.
Oh, you got to be. Absolutely have to be. This is going to be one of the fastest growing. And now, hold on, what do we got? Delay a game. Okay. I don't think they care much about a delay a game penalty here. You want to get out of here, but, you know.
No, the champagne is bubbling in South Beach right now. They just want to hit the showers and go hit Ocean Drive at this point.
Stanley again fades back, and she will take a knee.
There you go. All right.
Yeah, I got a little worried there. Yeah, moment. Yeah. I think you and I both. Oh no! Thank goodness that's the way it ends.
Yeah.
Well, 49
last 6 seconds.
Wow.
Yeah. This once again, you know, look for Miami to have a big, big game here against Tampa in a couple weeks. So it's been a fun game.
It has. Look at this. Terrific numbers for Miami. How do you get 361 yards, 49 points, and only 13 first downs? Mitch, there weren't many second downs for Miami.
Yeah.
They just threw the ball and just did a terrific job. And coming up, how about this one? We got a week off next week, and then Seattle with all fantasy players, Katie Reichman and Lindsey Blaine, against L.A. and Brittany DeGarbo. 2-0 Seattle, 1-1 L.A., a must win for L.A. to stay alive. Oh, what a huge, huge game for Los Angeles. That's down in Tinseltown, and it will be a big show in 2 weeks. That wraps it up. For Mitch Mortaza, I'm Tom Dorff, Miami with a big win. Good night, everybody.
Presentation of the Lingerie Football League.